Sarah Dillard, it's your girl Gabrielle Union. Let's go. You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's go.
There will be one, especially given how invested she is in the public discussion around sexual assault. A lot of times her tour stops felt like a revival, she said. After reading that, you knew for me it was on, and I had to try to make this happen. Please welcome once again tonight's brain food guest chef, Ms. Gabrielle.
Essays that are in the book started off as homework assignments in therapy. I know as Black folks, we look at therapy as mind shrinkers or people who are going to try to plant ideas in your mind, and all you need is Jesus and your parents. Again, I'm here to tell you, that's not the case. Our family's area of expertise. There's all sorts of issues that maybe we don't feel safe enough or comfortable enough to discuss with the people closest to us, and we need a professional. Luckily, I had parents who, when I was raped, recognized that this is beyond their area of expertise, and I was immediately put into therapy probably about 5 days after I was raped.
She came to Little Rock and spoke on a Saturday, and packed and had this impassioned conversation about sexual assault. The challenge sometimes for us is that we don't hear the message if we don't know who the messenger is. And I'm always thankful when someone says, I have a platform, I want to use it to give a broader message. And you deal with this a little bit in the book. So talk a little bit about the thinking about being compelled, or your thoughts about how do I use my platform to address this and other very important issues?
So basically, when you're in Hollywood, questions. I know your professors have said, and teachers throughout your life have said, there's no such thing as stupid questions. And I'm here to tell you, that's a lie. There are tons of stupid questions that get asked repeatedly over and over and over again. And I just got asked one too many stupid questions on the wrong day. And I said, enough. If I'm going to have these microphones shoved in my face, I'm going to feed my community. And I'm not feeding anyone talking about who's a better kisser, Will Smith or Jamie Foxx. Will Smith. Collectively, we're starving. And when we're looking to the people with the microphone, we can either nourish our minds and our souls, or we can continue the cycle of feeding our people crap. And I wanted to break that cycle. And that's really how it came to be. I just got fed up at the right moment. This last summer, this last July, was the 25th anniversary of my rape. I've been talking about being a rape survivor for 20 years. So well before the Me Too movement was created by Teron Burke, the hashtag MeToo movement, well before we were talking about Harvey Weinstein, Hollywood, sexual predators, and sexual predators that lurk in every corner of our global community, I was attempting to provide a face and a story that people could relate to and hopefully be moved by enough to shift their thinking about what it is to be a victim, what it is to be a survivor, and how that doesn't have to define who you are.
I have a question about getting people's opinions on you. What is something that you say to yourself when you find yourself wanting someone's validation or thinking about what somebody thinks of you?
Would reach representative for a lot of people be there? Is this the person I'm trusting with my truth? So is this the person I'm trusting with my sanity and my peace? Not to look at other things any outside of your ability and your talent. And you need to study. You need to decide, do I want to be famous or do I want to do the work? Because most of the time, those two things are very separate. You know what I'm saying? There's so many people that are fed by fear. theater, and that is their love. And there's so many people that say that and, you know, want to be Instagram models. So it's really about, do I want to do the work? Knowing that with the work may not come money, may not come fame, but your soul will be fed every day that you wake up and you are an artist. And you just have to be true to yourself and protect your brand, i.e. your talent, at all costs.